Go ahead, Jim.
You feel the team has moved on. You put the low house take enemy line, and now you're focused on Temple right now.
Right, we got to focus on each team, each different team each week. We got to put beside, like, put back what happened last week and just move on. Like, that was a big loss for us. Like, sucks. You know, we invested so much in it, but we got to move forward. We got to go get number one. We got to beat Temple.
A loss like that, tougher to put out of your mind when you're down three in the fourth quarter. You have, you know, you're within striking distance, and then you aren't able to pull it out.
Right, you know, yeah. It sucks. We just got to finish.
Yeah,
and that's the thing. We need to finish. We'll work on that all week. And we'll take it to Temple on Saturday.
And talk a little bit about Temple. What do you see in them, and what's the challenges there?
Good defense, well coached. You know, we got to come out there with our A game because they're a really good football team. They beat Vanderbilt last week, so you know we got to come out there with our A game and just leave it all out on the field.
And the ball against Ohio State, you put the ball on the ground a couple of times. Is that something you talk about cleaning up, making sure the ball doesn't?
Right. You know, we're like the least team that have turnovers. So, right. You know, that's our bread and butter. We got to make sure we take care of the ball. Make sure that we do that. Defense plays well. And we'll win games. That's our formula.
You have any lines?
I'm good.
Okay. Thanks, Noah.
Thanks, Noah.
So, ask Noah about putting Saturday's game behind you. Just your thoughts on that. And you guys are, you moved on fully and you're focused on Temple already.
Yes, sir. I mean, if we want to finish out the season the way we want to, it's already got to be behind us, which it is. You know, I came out here first practice of the week and get ready for Temple.
Your thoughts on how you play? I mean, you're in the backfield a lot against Ohio State, a couple tackles for loss, a sack. I mean, you're really disruptive.
You know, there's some things I gotta definitely work on, which is it's good, you know, first game of the season. You go out there, you play hard, you play fast, but you know, a lot of times you get a little bit too antsy, and you kind of gotta have like a controlled patience when you play the game, like a violent patience. If that makes sense, but
yeah,
you know, you just gotta focus on that technique and get back to the basics and fundamentals, and we'll get better and improve from where we were the first game.
And defensively, what do you have to do to kind of control that game against Temple?
You know, we just gotta get in the film room, you know, pick up on what they're trying to do on the offensive side of the ball. Definitely work on our technique at each position, you know, not get caught with our eyes in the wrong places, focusing on our keys and making all the right reads and just rallying to the football, making plays.
You talk about the importance of not going 0-2 to start the season. I mean, does this make this game a little bit more important in any way?
Yeah, and yes and no. I mean, starting off 0-2 would definitely suck, but you know, like we said, we're putting last week behind us. You know, right now we're working on win number one. That's our mindset right now, and we're gonna come out here every day and continue to work hard and get after that first win.
Well, appreciate that. Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Thanks, Paul.
Yeah. You feel like the team has moved on already mentally from the loss?
Yeah, well, I mean, it's in human nature. You're still going to be down. But the one remedy is come on, just work hard and try to press forward. You know, and I thought our guys did a decent job today of trying to do that.
For you, was it just come in Sunday morning, just start looking at tape and getting ready for Temple?
No, I don't come work on Sunday.
Yeah.
I got here at 3 this morning.
Okay, yeah.
And I just try to press forward. You know, it's hard, but you got to move on.
Yeah.
Whether we had won or lost, you'd have to put in your rearview mirror and move. But the pain hurts. But we got a very good team. We're getting ready to play, and we got to get ready.
Can you use that pain kind of as motivation going into the next game? Do you think?
Well, nobody likes to lose.
Yeah.
I think you're right, Jim. We don't like that feeling. We thought we worked hard, but it still wasn't good enough, so our guys recognized that we're playing against a team that got after Vanderbilt at their place. They're going to be at home. So if we have any kind of, you know, residual hangover or mourning, so to speak, you know, it's going to be another one.
And as far as, you know, put the ball on the ground a couple of times against Ohio State, is that something that you talked about cleaning up or addressed at all?
Yeah, and I mean, it's... You know, you get spoiled a little bit because you never drop the ball.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's just we've been so clean with it. Mm-hmm. And it wasn't like they're all over the place. You know, one hit the mod right here, two right in their hands. So, but, you know, we definitely got to get better at that. But there are a lot of good stuff that happened, too. Mm-hmm. So I don't want to delve too much on that. I mean, you know, I thought the last yard, we had 400 yards rushing.
Yeah.
That was the last time someone rushed for 400 yards against Ohio State. So. But like you said, we got to fix those things, but also try to get on.
You had alluded to it on Saturday, but it's so much time and invested, emotional and physical investment in that game. Talking about moving on again, that you've got 6 days to prepare for this opponent now. Do you feel good that your guys can, you know, not have the hangover, as you were mentioning?
Yeah, because I think we're here. You know what I mean? To me, the analogy that I use to the team is just, we got ready for that. You know, we weren't ready, getting ready for a 5K
right.
run. You know what I mean? You got ready for a marathon. You knew how good the team was. So I think it just forced all of our team and everybody to go crazy. And we just got to keep going up. You know what I mean? I like where we're at right now. Just got to continue to go.
Obviously, one thing you worry about when you play an opponent that physical on both sides of the ball is whether they beat up. Do you feel like you came out of the game in pretty good shape?
For the most part, we did. Yeah. I mean, so
that's kind of telling you something about your own.
You know, just like you said, it was a physical ball game on both sides of the ball. I thought we held it really good against the run. Our defense, and I thought we ran the ball well in offense. It was, you know, physical defense. So I was pleased with the way our guys played physically. And, you know, we got to get ready for another physical team.
And your thoughts, I mean, in essence, this is going to be a three-game road trip to start the season. That game was not as much of a home game. It's 1-1 at
Whoa, there's a lot of red on there.
Yeah, right.
Yes.
But, I mean, I haven't even got that far. You know what I mean? Just, you know, take it a game at a time. And all of our focus is on tempo. And, you know, try to get all of our energy. Like you said, it's a short, not a short week. It's a normal week. But you don't have 8 months to prepare for it. So we just got to get all of our energy.
Thanks, guys. Similar to what Ivan was saying, so probably some good, some bad. Let's start with the positive. I've thought Chris Johnson and William Tweeter played outstanding. Your thoughts?
Yeah, we had some some guys I thought played real. Chris Johnson did play real well. William Anthony did a good job.
Yeah, he got in the backfield and made some.
Tweeter made some plays. Bernie did a good job in the middle. And, you know, I thought first college game starting for all three inside backers, you know, at that position, Jordan, Gonzalez and Jimmy Britton, you know, for the first game against the number 5 team in the country. You know, I thought they did a good job. They did some good things. Quincy Adams, I thought, made some plays, did some good things. But good things, a lot of positives, but, you know, too many mistakes that didn't allow us to get the job done.
No, obviously, Quazell, that's an unfortunate thing, and you get exposed when you're playing. That's one of the things of playing secondary. Yeah. Everybody sees your mistakes. But moving over from corner to rover, do you think that's something that he hadn't seen in the game, or did he just read it?
He stopped his feet, or, you know, eyes not in the right place, just a little hesitation, and guy's got great speed.
Right, he's going to go right by you.
And,
right,
up to that point, Quazell was probably playing as well as anybody on the field. I mean, he made a ton of plays, made a big-time play on fourth down stop, and, you know, he probably was having as good a game as anybody on that field. But, you know, back there, you make a mistake, you know, it costs you six. So, you know, unfortunate it happened.
What do you tell your group, your unit, about moving on? You got to get rid of for a Temple team to put up a lot of points against Vanderbilt. You kind of just got to reemphasize, this is over. I'm sure you do a film review and go over things.
Yeah, we got to learn from our mistakes and, you know, take the positive. But there's a lot of things that we got to correct and we got to get better. We got to get better in a hurry because we're facing a very, very potent offense that can score a lot of points and score a lot of points in a hurry. They go in the SEC country last week and just, you know, blow Vanderbilt out in a short period. That game was over in the third quarter. And they've got a lot of weapons. They got a lot of speed. They got great size up front. And it's going to be a huge challenge for us going on the road for a second week in a row. You know, we got to be ready to play.
Now, you guys traditionally over the last few years have rolled a lot of defensive linemen. It didn't seem like that happened on Saturday. I don't know. Did Aaron Davis play a lot of snaps?
Yeah, Aaron played. We rolled three guys at outside, three guys at inside, and Aaron played inside. You know, we only played 50-some snaps. I mean, we only played six snaps in the third quarter. We didn't play many snaps that
right.
as a defense.
So did you feel like your guys did get worn down in the fourth quarter when they went?
No, they didn't play many snaps.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we only played six snaps in the third quarter.
So the Ohio State just executed?
It's hard to get worn down when you play six snaps in the third quarter.
Mm-hmm.
Our guys were fresh. At the end, they did a great job blocking us. They got a great offense. I mean, they put 63, 65, 60-plus on a lot of people last year. We knew they were a great offense and could score points in a hurry. And they're big up front. They got great backs. And they did a good job execution in the second half.
All right. All right. Thanks, Coach.
Yep.